Hello. Today we are going to discuss measurement of VSWR. So first thing is that what do you mean by the VSWR? VSWR means voltage standing wave ratio. First thing is that why SWR exists in a transmission line? As we know from the basic of the transmission line, if the load is perfectly matched to the characteristic impedance of the transmission line, then we can say the load is perfectly matched. But if the load is not equal to the characteristic impedance of the transmission line, then we are saying that the load is mismatched, right? So any mismatch between the load and the characteristic impedance of the transmission line causes a reflection of the wave, and due to this reflection wave and incident wave, a setup is formed, and that particular setup is known as a SWR, standing wave ratio. To understand the SWR, first we will consider a simple transmission line where a simple source is connected, right? This is the source, and this source is connected with to a particular load. This is a load with the help of transmission line, right? So this is the simple connection of a transmission line between the source and load. This transmission line offers a certain impedance, and this particular impedance is known as a Z0. And the load which is connected at the output line of the transmission line is represented by again an impedance that is known as ZL. For the maximum power transfer, there is a condition that Z0 should be equal to the ZL. That means the characteristic impedance of the transmission line should be equal to the load impedance, right? If this Z0 is not equal to ZL, so we can say this is your unmatched transmission line, right? Due to the unmatched or due to the mismatch of the transmission line, there is a reflected wave, and there is a incident wave from the source side. So the incident wave and the reflected wave makes a pattern, and that particular pattern or setup is known as a SWR, right? The SWR are of two types. One is known as a voltage standing wave ratio, and second is known as a current standing wave ratio. That means if this pattern is represented in the voltage form, then it is known as a VSWR. Then it is known as a VSWR, and if this standing wave pattern is represented in your current form, then it is known as a CSWR, right? So here we are going to discuss VSWR, means voltage standing wave ratio. So this is the simple diagram of your VSWR, right? Here this pattern is set up by the reflected wave and incident wave. Here we will get two voltages. One is known as a Vmax and second is known as a Vmin, right? So Vmax is the voltage which offers maximum at a certain frequency or a certain wavelength. In a similar manner, the Vminimum is the voltage which offers the minimum value of the voltage at a particular wavelength, or we can say frequency. The difference between, that means a voltage minimum and a voltage maximum, the distance between these two is known as a lambda G by 4, and the distance between the V minimum and the V minimum, that means we can say the difference between the two minimum voltage is your lambda G by 2, right? And the distance between the two maximum, this is your maximum value, will also be your lambda G by 2. So this is a fixed electrical length, so we can say at quarter wavelength, at every quarter wavelength, maxima will move towards the minima and minima will move towards the maxima after a quarter wavelength, right? And we can say after a half wavelength electrical length, the voltage maxima repeats itself. That means the distance between the two maxima is lambda g by 2. So we can say the two maxima or maxima repeats itself at a distance of lambda g by 4. This is your electrical length. Electrical length means this is the length. This is the length of transmission line. Right? If this is the position at which we get the Vmax, so after lambda g by 4 distance, we will also get Vmax. If this is a Vmin, then after lambda g by 4 distance, we will also get a Vminimum. So this is the simple representation of your VSWR. So as we have discussed, the standing wave ratio is defined as the ratio of voltage maxima to the voltage minima. That means if in a particular transmission line we know what is the value of Vmax and what is the value of Vmin, then we are able to easily calculate the value of VSWR, right? And suppose we have a value of reflection coefficient rho, so we can also calculate the value of standing wave ratio with the help of this reflection coefficient. So the value of this one here will be negative. That means the value of S will be 1 plus rho divided upon 1 minus rho. If the line is perfectly terminated to its load impedance, so the value of this reflection coefficient will be 0. So the minimum value of SWR will be 1. Right? And if the load is highly mismatched between, then the value of reflection coefficient will be 1, right? So here 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. So 2 upon 0 will be your infinite. So the maximum value of voltage standing wave ratio will be infinite and the minimum value of standing wave ratio would be 1, right? So here we are seeing that rho is the reflection coefficient, and reflection coefficient rho is defined by the P reflected upon P incidence. That means what is the power which is reflected by the load and what is the power incident by the source. As rho varies from 0 to infinite, hence S varies from 1 to infinite. So the minimum value of S is unity. That means we have previously calculated if the value of rho will be 0, because this is the condition for the perfectly matched, right? So the value of rho will be 0. That means we can say 1 plus 0 on 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. So the minimum value of standing wave ratio will be unity. The following methods are used to measure the VSWR in microwave transmission line. The first one method is slotted line techniques, which is used to calculate the value of VSWR which has less than 10. Right? If the value of VSWR is greater than 10, then we will use a second method, that is double minima method. So we can say depending on the value of SWR, the techniques is different. If the value of VSWR is low, then we will prefer slotted line technique. And if the value of VSWR is high, then we will prefer double minimum method. So let us see first technique. This is our slotted line technique. This is the block diagram of slotted line technique, right? This is the block diagram of slotted line technique. This is the general bench setup for the value of low SWR, right? That means we have to connect the devices in this manner. So this is nothing but your bench setup for the slotted line technique to measure the small values of VSWR. The first one is used to generate the microwave source. That means first one block will be generator, a signal generator, which is able to generate the microwave signal. To generate the microwave signal in the laboratory, we will use gun diode or reflex klystron, right? And the output of microwave source goes to the input of variable attenuator, where the output of the microwave source power can be varied depending on the requirement. Now, the output of variable attenuator goes to the slotted line. First thing, slotted line is nothing but your waveguide, where a slot is cut along the broader dimension, like this one. And there is also an important part that is known as a movable probe. Let us say this is a movable probe. So this movable probe is inserted in the slotted line. So the whole assembly of this one is known as a slotted line, right? The output of the slotted line, this slotted line, is goes to the load, or the load which is used to test, or whose VSWR is to be calculated will be connected here, right? One terminal which is outputted from the movable probe goes to the crystal detector. The crystal detector detects the microwave signal and it goes to the VSWR meter, right? And the VSWR meter directly reflects the value of VSWR, what is the reflect voltage maxima or voltage minima. Clear? So this was the general bench setup for the slotted line technique. So when the line is terminated with the unmatched load impedance of the characteristic impedance of the line, the incident and reflected waves set a standing wave on the line. That particular standing wave is known as a voltage standing wave, right? So first of all, the probe on the slotted line is adjusted to give maximum voltage, right? And detector is tuned to give maximum output. So first we will calculate a simple Pmax, or or we can say Pr, that is your Vmax, maximum voltage, right? And after this one we will calculate V minimum, now we will take the ratio of V max to the V minimum, that will directly reflects the value of standing wave ratio, right? Here the attenuator is now adjusted to get full scale deflection on the meter. The full scale reading is noted. Next, the probe on the slotted line is adjusted to get minimum reading on the meter corresponding to Vmin. This reading is also noted. The ratio of Vmax to Vmin gives the value of VSWR. That means in the slotted line, this movable probe is moved to detect the maximum voltage. That means this movable probe, let us say this is your VSWR, right? This is the value of VSWR and this is the value of Vmax, this is the value of V minimum, right? So the movable probe is adjusted to deflect the maximum voltage. That means maximum voltage standing, and mean the point at which we will get maximum voltage, that particular voltage would be noted with the help of this VSWR meter and by changing the position of this movable probe, right? If suppose if the movable probe is at this point, so we will move the movable probe towards the left side so that the voltage is increasing. At from this point, the voltage is goes to increasing, and after that particular point, the voltage is now just depressed or decreasing. So this is the point at which we are going the Vmax. So this particular point or voltage is noted with the help of VSWR meter, and after that we further move the movable probe in a such a way that we will get the minimum voltage on the VSWR. Now we will take the ratio of Vmax to the Vmin, right? The ratio of Vmax to Vmin represents the direct reading of the VSWR, that is voltage standing wave ratio. So with the help of this slotted line technique, we are easily able to calculate the voltage standing wave ratio which has a very low value. For example, FSD of 10 millivolt corresponds to a VSWR of 1, right? The traveling probe is adjusted to get minimum reading on the meter, right? If this corresponds to 5 millivolt, that means we have recorded the maximum, or FSD is your 10 millivolt, and the minimum reading is calculated as 5 millivolt, then VSWR will be 10 millivolt upon the 5 millivolt, that will be your 2. So this is the value of VSWR. Second thing is that to get the full scale reading, we will also adjust the value of variable attenuator. That means we will change the value of attenuator such that the meter records FSD. FSD means full scale deflection, right? Full scale of that particular reading. So with the help of this one, we will get 10. So suppose FSD reading is your Vmax, and Vmax is equal to 10 millivolt, and V minimum reading is your 5 millivolt. So VSWR will be 10 by 2 is equal to 2. This is the simple, right? Now, if the VSWR value is greater than 10, then we will use another method that is known as a double minima method, right? What is the double minima method? The setup for this method would be the same as the previous one, but the difference is that in this method we will position movable probe or moving detector such that we get a value of V minimum. Now we move the movable probe or moving detector towards the left, where we could get the double voltage of the minima. Suppose if here we are getting 2 millivolt, so this is the point would be where we could have a value of 4 volt, right? Similarly, by taking the value of this one, so where we will get the double voltage of minima is noted, and suppose this particular position is D1. Now this particular D1 is noted, and now we again move towards the V minima, and now we will move opposite direction. That means in the first case we have moved in the left hand side, now we will move towards the right hand side. Now we will record the voltage on the VSWR such that it reflects the double minima voltage, or under root 2 minimum, right? Under 2 multiplied by the V minimum. That particular voltage is noted. Where we will get that particular voltage under root 2 minimum, that distance is noted D2. Now this is the position also where the under root 2 minimum is noted. So we will take the difference between the two, that means D2 minus D1. Now with the help of this formula, we are able to easily calculate the value of VSWR, right? So VSWR is equal to the lambda G upon pi D2 minus D1. So with the help of this one, we are able to calculate the double minimum method. So we can say the measurement of VSWR meter in microwave is much, much easier than the other. Thank you for today.